Agent Shaz, are you ready for our review?
Wait, are you trying to be a Russian spy?
I am a Russian spy.
Dude, you gotta stop auditioning for Hollywood, man. Movie Fanboys. Just came back from Pavilion. Yep. And witnessed the man from
Uncle.
Okay, so basically it's about an agent in the CIA named
Paul Solo
and a Russian spy
Ilya Kuryakin for the KGB
joining forces to stop the development of nuclear warheads.
Yeah,
shit is about to go down old school style,
more like grandpa style.
So bro, what do you think about the movie?
It was very entertaining. I like the whole James Bond vibe to it. Mm-hmm. And I really like a movie based from the 50s or 40s spy genre combined. It has a really nice touch to it.
To be honest, I don't know jack shit about this movie.
Jack shit.
Never heard about the man from Uncle.
Mm, me too.
I don't know about the director. All I know is the guy from Man of Steel is there.
Henry Cavill. My man crush.
Not much hype of the movie, but very entertaining.
This movie was directed by Guy Ritchie, who made a lot of great films like Snatch, Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels. And his last movie was Sherlock Holmes Game of Shadows, and which was released in 2011. Finally make a movie.
After four years.
Which, as you know, is based from the 1960s TV series, which all our grandpas and grandmas used to watch.
Yeah, which we didn't even know about.
Mm-hmm. This movie shows the origin of how the two of them met.
So it's a refreshing take on secret spy, because we've seen a lot of modern age spy lately. It's a mixture of James Bond, smart humor,
very witty, yeah.
Witty of Mission Impossible. You fuse them up, add a bit of 70s style in it.
Henry Cavill, he actually look like a James Bond in this movie. There's some certain part you can actually see is James Bond. At some certain point, you can actually see that he's
Man of Steel.
Yeah. We haven't seen any of his work. And in this movie, we finally see his true talent.
Humorous too.
And humorous too. So with that being said, he stole the show for me.
Yeah, he stole the show. Do you know Archer?
Archer.
My favorite cartoon show.
Oh yeah, man.
Man. Henry Cavill can pull Archer.
Let's talk about Rami Hammer, man. The KGB guy. The way he spoke in Russian.
Wow.
Well,
I'm not Russian, but I guess he pulled it off.
I think for most Russians, I think they would be very disappointed.
His acting was a level up this time.
This time, yeah, of course. Yeah. I love the chemistry between Henry Cavill's character.
He has that love-hate relationship, but it works out beautifully.
Beautifully, yeah. A female character, man.
Gabby.
Gabby, which is played by Alicia Vikander, if I pronounce her name correctly.
She is the bond between the two of these masculine agents. She played her role very well.
She's not like any other typical female characters.
She's kind of tough.
Yeah, she's kind of tough. Yeah. Finally, to see a female character is trying to do something in the story.
Yep, yep.
Ex Machina. Remember that movie? Yeah, she's the robot chick, man.
Is she?
Yeah.
The actual robot.
The actual robot. Yeah.
Oh man, I was just looking at her body. That's it. But
yeah,
that's her.
That's her, man. Yeah. I was surprised. Oh, that's the girl from Ex Machina.
Oh, okay. Now I remember. Mm-hmm. Yeah, her butt was the same shape, though.
This guy. His observations never stops. Yeah, she's...
I'm a visual guy.
Yeah. The villain.
Villain.
Yeah, it was too weak for me. Every movie needs a very good villain.
A prominent one.
Yeah,
basically it was just chasing around nuclear warheads, blueprints, and... you know, location, that's it. Yeah. It was more of a one-sided movie, yeah, where it just showcased the good guys.
Yeah, it's all about the chemistry between the guys. I mean, the characters between Henry Cavill and Armie Hammer.
Yeah. Somewhere in the middle, the second act, they could have shortened that a bit.
Could have shortened a lot, actually.
There was a few yawnings.
Yeah.
I was like, a bit, but they, unlike Fantastic Four, the third act, it does not beat Mission Impossible,
but it's alright.
It's alright.
Editing part was quite cool too, you know. He has a different kind of style to
and it. There's a twist which we didn't see coming,
you know.
So that was quite cool. Nobody can twist our mind by this one, did it?
Yeah, you didn't see this coming at all.
Like, oh damn.
Humor
was smart.
Was smart, yeah. I love the humor, yes, that British humor into it. The humor really worked well in this movie. And not just the lines that actually work, even the direction works. I was laughing, remember the part?
Yeah, I remember the part.
Yeah, we're not gonna spoil it for you. But that was really amazing. It is safe to say that this movie has the potential. I really hope that they are able to do sequels, you know?
At the end of the day, you guys should catch Man of U.N.C.L.E. Based on the 50s, 60s style. It's quite refreshing.
It's interesting.
Yeah, you should watch it.
Watch it, man. Okay, we're gonna rate this movie, so we're gonna give it
a 3.5.
Yeah.
Popcorns. Okay, that's all for now. Hope you guys enjoy our review.
Do support our channel and join our community by sharing, like, and subscribe.
Yeah, be a clone troopers. Give us a thumbs up if you love this review. Stay tuned for more. This is Shaz.
I'm Syam. Thank you for watching, guys. And
peace. Privyet. Russian.
Full attack. Not only
this point. It's all done! Oh yeah!
Oh, better! I think that Kevin Feige is knocking 20th Century Fox office right now. Hello? Hello?
Hello, anybody home? Alright, that's our rant. Hope you guys enjoy our complaints. Do support our channel.